Dolphins leave a trail of light behind them when they swim. Surfers catch glowing waves. The images could be straight out of Avatar or Tron. But this isn't CGI. These enchanting displays of light are created by living organisms through a chemical reaction called bioluminescence. About 76% of marine life is capable of producing bioluminescent light, including some species of fish, squid, and jellyfish. The most common bioluminescent organisms are marine plankton called dinoflagellates. The name comes from combining the Greek word for dinos, which means whirling, and the Latin flagellum, meaning whip. This is in reference to the distinctive way that they spin as they swim. Dinoflagellates live in the surface layers of the sea and are what's creating the sparkling luminescence that we've been seeing in these videos. I'm KP, I'm a marine biologist, and today we're going to grow our own bioluminescent plankton. I'm so excited about this. This is actually not a paid sponsorship, by the way. I just think this is super cool. So for this video, I thought it'd be really neat to have a visual aid. And I think this is one of the coolest products that you could buy. Let me show you. It's a bioluminescent orb by a company called Pyrofarms. Let's unbox it. Now, it's obviously perishable. I really haven't been this excited since unboxing my first thing of sea monkeys when I was 12 years old. So, oh Jesus, love this. Dude, stop. Now, this, I'm so scared I'm gonna drop this. This is where I'm going to grow the bioluminescent algae inside of this glass orb. The entire setup was way easier than I thought it would be. The whole process took just a few minutes, and that includes multiple outtakes. Is that a sticker? I love stickers and other shenanigans. I have to move this because the ferrets are like feral. Okay, okay, it fits in there. So that's helpful because this is scary. Ooh, all right. I can see things in here. Can you see this? Hold on. Bring it close. Like, there's stuff in there, guys. Dude, and they're moving. And now we wait. The specific type of bioluminescent dinoflagellate sent to me by Pyrofarms is Pyrocystis fusiformis, also known as pyrodinos. Scientists believe the production of bioluminescence by pyrodinos is a defense mechanism that startles grazing fish, which would otherwise eat them. Possibly actually illuminates the grazers so that they are more visible to their own predators. This is known as the burglar alarm hypothesis. Other animals use bioluminescence to attract mates, communicate with other animals, or to entice prey. A famous example is the anglerfish that uses a luminescent fin ray as a lure. Squid and jellyfish have luminescent tentacles that draw in small fish, like moths, to a flame. Beyond their mesmerizing beauty, pyrodinos and other bioluminescent plankton potentially have some groundbreaking applications in the fields of architecture, medicine, and conservation. And if you've been watching this channel for any given time, then you know that conservation is kind of my thing. Because these algae can produce light, scientists are currently looking into how bioluminescent organisms could be used to make sustainable outdoor lighting in public spaces. They're also developing indoor lighting for people's homes. These bioluminescent powered lamps are called biolamps. One example is this brass lighting fixture developed by a Dutch designer. This lamp doesn't use typical incandescent bulbs. Instead, its light source is the bioluminescent bacteria found on octopus tentacles. And now I want one of those too. In the field of medicine, bioluminescence is one of the most effective ways to monitor the cleanliness of surfaces in healthcare facilities like hospitals and clinics. It is currently used for drug screening, bioimaging of live organisms, cancer studies, and the investigation of infectious diseases. There are so many uses for bioluminescence that I simply don't have time to cover them all. So if you want to learn more, I'll drop links to the studies and articles in the descriptions, which I am now being told are over here currently, as well as a link to Pyrofarms where you can get your very own set of bioluminescent pyrodinos to grow in your home. Speaking of which, it's time to check out my dinos. It's been a few days and they've had time to grow and to acclimate. So the dinoflagellates actually fall into a circadian rhythm, meaning that you can only see the bioluminescence after a certain time of night. So let's turn off the lights and check it out.
All right. Whoa, bro. Oh my God. How cool is that? No, stop. Dude, I feel like a wizard. I'm an actual wizard.
Even though bioluminescent technology has quickly reached several uncharted territories, it does have a long way to go. Octopus bacteria only live for a few days, and pyrodinos only emit light when disturbed by movement or environmental changes, and they need sunlight and time in order to regenerate. Another problem is, as I mentioned, pyrodinos only glow at night because of their circadian rhythm.
Zaz not showing up.
No. I feel like this is too light out.
We can wait. Yeah. Let's wait.
But a word of caution if you're thinking about swimming or surfing these iridescent waves. While this looks like a once-in-a-lifetime experience, these breathtaking waves may be a warning sign that the water is unsafe. As I mentioned, bioluminescence from algae can be triggered by environmental changes. Changes like pollution, for instance. In fact, the most widely used bioluminescence application is in the monitoring of toxicology in ecosystems, also known as pollution mapping. Other environmental changes that can trigger bioluminescence are low oxygen and high nitrogen levels in the water. While dinoflagellates like pyrodinos from pyrofarms are perfectly safe and non-toxic.
Non-toxic? You were asking about that.
Yeah.
Still don't drink them though.
That's not the case for all bioluminescent algae. Many bioluminescent species are very toxic, and toxic algae reproduce and grow rapidly in low oxygen and high nitrogen conditions, resulting in a harmful algal bloom called red tide. Millions of overgrown toxic algae change the color of the water to red in daylight and cause it to sparkle at night. So, as alluring as it might be, always make sure that the water is safe before swimming or surfing in these sparkling waves. Or you could just head over to Pyroforms and get yourself some for your home, if you want. Like I said, I think this is so cool. This has quickly become one of my favorite things in my house, and I think you'll like it too.
It's still so cool. That was dark, so I feel like it's not quite as cool right now. How's it looking?
It's looking pretty cool.
Dude, I feel like a wizard. I'm an actual wizard.
They are not all accounted for, the lost seeing stones. We do not know who else may be watching.